What is up, guys? Another day, another project here on the Civic. While we're waiting on parts, I figured I might as well do a project that is definitely not up on the high up on the priority list, but you know, that's typically how it goes with me. Kind of start doing things that I want to do and not things that necessarily need to be done right now. And one of those things is replacing the tint, redoing the tint on this car. And I know, calm down everyone. I know you don't have to take the entire door panel off and take the window out to tint. I'm doing it the hard way. Well, not necessarily the hard way for me, because I had to take the door panel out anyways, because as everything else on this car, it was filthy. And so I just barely got done hosing that off, spraying it off, just scrubbing the living daylights out of it. And with the door panel already off, it's not much more involved. Literally just peeling this back. And then we've got two bolts there. They're already out, and I'm just gonna pull out the window. I have done tint the normal way, just rolling down the window, laying the tint, rolling it up. You know, that's typical. But it'll be nice to not have to worry about the seals or anything like that. And I'll be able to take the tint all the way to the bottom as well and not run the risk of it getting caught or anything like that. But yeah, so that'll be nice. And the reason why we're doing this is, I don't know if you can see here, but there are scratches in the tint. I tried actually buffing them out on the other window. They didn't come out. And so that's what we're gonna be doing. And yeah, just keeping going, keeping plugging on this thing. So we're gonna get the window out. It's already unbolted. Just pull it out and we'll start peeling the tint. Guys, this has been absolutely ridiculous. Just an absolute battle. So they use an adhesive for the tint, and I'm pretty sure, so when I tinted the windows on the Z, it was just a it was like an activated adhesive. It was just part of the tint, and I just don't know if this is just cheap tint or what, or I don't know, but just like, look at this. I've just been peeling absolute layers off of this stuff off the window, and so you can see some there in the light, and we've just about got it. I've been going at this for like an hour. Just got a little bit left at the bottom, as you can see there. I mean, I've had to take the razor blade. I've just been, this stuff, if you guys don't know about this, this stuff's really good. It especially on like painted surfaces and just things you don't want just destroyed by a chemical, this stuff really works well, and it just really does the job. But this adhesive is just either so old or just so caked on that I've just been having to soak, and it's finally starting to penetrate the adhesive. It's really coming off now. So we're just about done. So wish me luck, and then we can get to getting the new tint on there. Okay guys, so tinting windows is not an incredibly difficult thing to do. It's actually relatively simple. That being said, it is a little tricky, and you can completely screw it up. But again, it's pretty simple. So here I'll just give you kind of a rundown of the setup here. You obviously need your tint, you have 5% VLT3M in there, and we've got our little tool bag. I got this off Amazon a while ago for like literally I think is like $5. I don't know if you can get it that cheap anymore, but it came with everything you need. So you're gonna need an X-Acto knife, squeegees you are going to need. This is actually the squeegee I will be using, this blue one, because I can put new felt on it. You want to make sure this is good and clean. You don't want to be scratching up your fresh tint. This one kind of makes a mess, so I'm not going to use that one. That is really about it. I used to have a really nice rubber squeegee, like a handheld, had a very soft rubber edge to it. And I used that when I tinted the Z's window, but I cannot find it, so we'll have to make use with this. Other than that, the key ingredient's going to be soapy water. It's just an 8-ounce bottle with 3 squirts of Dawn dish soap. You gotta get your window clean. So we got the window right here. We're going to be bringing this in. And you're gonna wanna make sure this is very clean, obviously. Front, or the side you're tinting, of course, but also the back. You don't want anything, you just really want a clean area. You just wanna avoid getting any debris or any dust behind the tint, so you have bubbles or anything like that. So I'll just kind of quickly run through it and show you how to get started.
Obviously, most of you are going to be doing this on your car where the windows are actually still on the car. A little bit different situation here, so just get the edges clean as best you can. You really just want a clean workspace everywhere. Okay, so like I've said, the concept is relatively simple. You're just going to be spraying soapy water across the window, laying the film on top of that, squeegeeing out the soapy water from behind the film, and then cutting the outline of the window. So yeah, that's pretty much it, and we'll get to it.
Okay, with the tint laid out, So something to keep in mind, or something to understand, there's a clear protective layer that's kind of, it's like peeling the back off of a sticker. So on the bottom side of this tint is that clear layer. Make sure you lay down that side first. And what you're going to do is you're going to roll it back from underneath the best you can. That way we make sure we kind of keep the tint down, keep dust out. The most difficult part, honestly, of tinting a window is probably peeling the clear off of the back. It's just really, it's hard to get it started. You kind of just gotta find an edge that's far away from your window. And I just start rolling it like this, if you can see that. I just kind of pinch it in my fingers until I can get that back layer kind of separated from the tint. Start straightening it out and really get to squeegeeing. That's pretty much it. Okay, at this point it's relatively straight. We're now going to start trimming just a little bit. That way we don't have a ton of excess material around the edges. Okay, the other thing is you now want to soapy water the front side of the tint. This is to ensure or prevent the best you can any sort of scratching, because this is actually your window now. So you want to make sure you're not scratching the crap out of your tint as you're applying it. So this is just kind of an added safety. I'm actually going to go ahead and put a fresh new felt on this squeegee just for an added layer of caution. Get it soaked up as well. Kind of just start in the middle and work your way out.
be very gentle with the tint. At this point, you're just basically putting it down and getting it where it goes. One other thing I'd like to mention, there's one of two things you can do. You can either lay it all out and let it dry and cut it later, or cut it as you're going along. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to cut the top frame of the window and then squeegee it all out, get it to lay down, and then I'll probably finish it off at the bottom later. I have found that it is easier to cut and trim to final perfection when it is dry, so that's something to keep in mind. Trickiest part, but as you can see, we have excess at the bottom, so if we were to screw up, we do have a little bit of margin of error, because then we can just slide it up and try it again. But you've only got so many shots of that, so really you just want to get the top as best you can. And very sharp X-Acto knife. Honestly, you've got to run basically a new blade every time you're tinting. I thought I had a very sharp blade when I started my other window. It turns out it just was not sharp enough and I'd only used it a couple times. So really, if you're starting a new job, you want to start out with a fresh new blade. That is pretty much it as far as the process goes. I will get back to you when this thing's dry. Let's go. And that is how you tint a window for no more than $10. That's right, I spent $9 on this tint, did it myself, and it turned out pretty well. Looking very nice. Take a look inside. We did end up with one bubble right there. You can't see it, but all in all, turned out very nice, and I'm a big fan of the 5% tint. Looks super nice, and I was worried it was going to be darker than the rear tint, but no, it is pretty much the same, so super pumped about that. Looks very nice on the Civic, so yeah, take a look at that. That's nice and dark. I know the rear looks lighter, but it's just because it's super dusty. So guys, if you want to know how to tint your windows for less than $10, your two front windows, that's how you can do it. And until next time, peace out, and thanks for watching.